Those essays were written on different occasions, and they cover a large area of time. And the only thing is that it was addressed to audiences who were quite unaware of, like, for instance, Abindranath and this sort of thing. In fact, particularly, I mean, apart from the other essays, the Abindranath essay was done for his centenary seminar, which I couldn't attend. And I had gone to Santiniketan on a visit at that time, and they approached me with the kind of a request. So I said, how can I write about Abindranath when I haven't seen anything of his work? I had seen a few things which were around in Santiniketan, but there were very few. There was a large area of work which I had learned from a kind of a listing done by Benode Bihari in one of the Visva Bharati Quarterly numbers. And yeah, I haven't seen all this. Then I discovered that it was in the hands of this Rabindr Bharati Society. The background of it, as I understand it, is like this, that when in his later years, the Abindranath went bankrupt. The whole family couldn't sort of pay back their debts. So their part of the building in Dwarakanath Tagore Lane was sold off to some Marwadi. They sold all his paintings, I mean, he's here. And finally, he moved to a small house somewhere on the outskirts of
Oh, Calcutta.
Ah, Calcutta. And of course, he sat there and read some delightful things. I mean, sort of wrote. And one of them is this experience of moving and all the reveries around it. Now, this man, when this happened, when certain part of the Calcutta public thought that this was such a shame, so they raised some money and bought back that thing and put in this sort of a society. And it is in the sort of a safekeeping of the society, if you call that safekeeping. They have about, works of Abindranath and certain, and a larger collection of the works of other people of that time. About, I think, more than 2,500 works, all locked in three trunks. There are only two rooms in where they keep these things. And it is presided over one secretary who is always very unwilling to show it out to you. And they have a chairman who is generally hardly there, he only comes for the meeting. So when I wanted that, look, I want to see it, luckily the Visva Bharati vice-chancellor of that time, who is a known historian called Pratul Gupta. He said, I can arrange it, because he was on the committee and he had some say in the matter. So before coming to Baroda, I stopped by for 2 days in Calcutta and had a look at it. Then I found this fabulous treasure trove. I mean, there were about 600 works of Abindranath, out of which this Arabian Night series were the cream of the whole lot. And it was done as recorded. In the course of 1 year, 40 paintings of big size, it was done on the course of 1 year. Almost at the same time when he was delivering what are called the Bhageshwari lectures in art.
Was that in the 1930s?
It ended in the 1929 or 30. That's. But it started much earlier, the Bhageshwari lectures probably from 26 to 30 or something of that kind. Now, I mean, that was really an eye-opener. I had never seen anything like it before. So that is why I wrote that essay on the... The other thing that have come there, of course, is on the basis of a lecture here or a lecture there, things of that kind. And the art and change thing was delivered in Santiniketan again when I went from here on an extension lecture or visiting professor's lecture. So it was all brought together by Sheikh and these people. And now it has gone into a new edition.